Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and today we'll look at our LPI Level 1 certification and the 102 exam with client-side DNS. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin, and on Facebook you'll be able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. So in this video we're looking at the LPI Level 1 certification and Exam 102, Configuring Client-Side DNS. So according to the LPI, this is what they're going to be looking at. The weight is an indication of how many questions there should be from this topic in the exam. There'll be 60 questions in all, and maybe two of them will be on client-side DNS. We're going to be looking at configuring DNS on the local client and look at the name resolution order. So we'll be looking at the etc host file, the resolv.conf, and the name service switch.conf. So DNS, or the domain name services, is a way of resolving usually host names to IP addresses, but it also will look up things like the MX or mail exchange records, the email servers for a given domain, and we can reverse the lookups to look up the host name of an IP address. But this way we then don't have to worry about memorizing the IP addresses for domains like theurbanpenguin.com or ford.com or General Motors or whoever you want to go and visit. We can visit them by name. Traditionally we would add in the DNS server to search and our domain name information into the etcresolv.conf on Linux. On local clients, we might populate the etc host file, and we can control the order of that name resolution, as we mentioned before, through the nsswitch.conf. So we're working on the command line of my Raspberry Pi. For the LPI, it doesn't matter what distribution that you're using, but the Raspberry Pi is not such a bad idea to use because they're relatively cheap and you can easily access the command line through PuTTY if you don't have a Linux desktop that you want to use. So I've logged in as a standard user. I can read the information from the resolv.conf, so that's in the etc directory. I don't have too much in on this machine, it's just pointing through to the DNS server. If I needed to edit the file, I would have to have root access, so I can use sudo to gain root access. So sudo minus I will give me a bash prompt as root. And now I can edit the configuration file. I'm just going to use Vi, but you could use your own editors to look at the contents and change the contents of the file. You see, I've just got one name server entry, but very often we would start the file with an entry like search. If I put search theurbanpenguin.com, then if I put in a host name, let's say just www or labs or mail or whatever, then we will append it to theurbanpenguin.com, so it become labs.theurbanpenguin.com. I can also and would normally want multiple name servers in, so I can add in 8.8.4.4, the second Google server. So we'll try and resolve names from the first server, but if we can't resolve names from the 8.8 server, we can then move to the 4.4 server. With that in place then, we should be able to see the search working if I go ping labs, and we can see now that we're resolving the name of labs.theurbanpenguin.com. As well as being able to resolve domain names through the DNS system, we can resolve names through local files, and we have the etc hosts, or what's often called the local hosts file. Here we can put entries in that define hostname resolution just for this box. So we have an entry in by default that points to its own hostname, but if we needed to, we could put entries to other systems. This might be because you're working on a new system and you don't want it to be publicly resolvable by DNS, but you need to be able to access it. So you can access the new host before it goes live with the correct name. So it's a possibility that you can use this, but obviously on a major scale, we don't want to be putting lots of host file entries in. If I try and ping labs now, I've added in an entry for labs.theurbanpenguin.com, labs won't resolve because we have to use the resolv.conf to look for the search string. But if I actually try now and ping labs.theurbanpenguin.com, so not relying on the search, we're resolving the name from the local file rather than the DNS system. That's controlled. The order in which we evaluate the name services is through the nameserviceswitch.conf, so /etc/nsswitch.conf. And then as we go and have a look for the hosts entry, we're reading the files first and then DNS. But if I wanted to read the DNS first and then files, I could easily swap them around. So we'd only need to check the local files for names that weren't resolvable through the main DNS system.